All right, so now we are ready to upload files into your binder. So for this demonstration, I'm going to do an example of uploading a group of files for a particular set of requirements. So this is going to be for block one, class management. So what I want you to do is to log into your LiveBinders account and then move your mouse over to your welcome username over here in the upper right of the screen, and then a little menu will pop up and I want you to scroll down and click on My Uploaded Files. It's going to open up a new page, and over here on the left you're going to see a hyperlink that says Upload Files, Manage Uploaded Files. We're going to click on Upload Files. Okay, so I've got three files under Classroom Management for Block 1, and I'm going to select them and say Open. Now it's making sure that I haven't uploaded these before, so that should be good. If you get a pop-up that says, you know, you've already uploaded this file, are you sure you want to override it? Make sure that you do want to override it because it's going to replace that file. If you are not sure you had uploaded it before, go ahead and cancel and rename that file and upload it again. So we're going to say now, start upload. And once it's uploaded, it adds it to the manage uploaded files list. So now it's added to your uploaded files list and it's pre-selected. So now it's ready to be added to your binder. Add to binder. And it's going to give you this little pop-up window. I'm going to move it over here on the right. Okay, so it's already got your binder selected, so you don't have to do anything there. And now it's giving you a choice of where to put that. So let's go ahead and click on the little drop-down arrow. And I want you to select subtab, because it's going to help you select where in the binder you're going to put these files. So we said we were going to do this in block one. Now I want you to go back up and choose Base tab radial button, which is going to help you choose the subtab that you're going to put your file under, which is going to be the 1.05 Classroom Management Systems. And then I'm going to say Add to Binder. So it's going to take all those three files that I've selected and it's added them to the binder. Okay, so let's go ahead and take a look and see what that looks like. To go back to your My Binders page, you can either click on the My right here, or you can go back to your drop-down menu over here on the right and go to My Binders. And then I'm going to click on the binder icon to just go ahead and open it. I'm going to go to block one, and I'm going to go 1.05 Classroom Management Systems. And if you've uploaded your files correctly in that tab, you'll see them as purple base tabs here. So here's my tasks cover sheet. Here's my classroom management worksheet. And here's my classroom management observation sheet. And what's nice about saving all your files as PDFs is that PDFs are browser friendly and they will play and display that file right there in the tab so your viewers can read the documents that you're sharing with them. And Adobe provides a great way to like rotate the files if they are scanned off to its side. You can zoom in. I mean, Adobe provides all these great tools right there inside of the browser. And then your audience can always print from the binder or download right here. It'll just save it to whoever's desktop is viewing your binder. And that's how you add files to your binder.